This video is a follow-up video to my previous one where I present you with four different scenes and with a list whether you are going to go with normalization or not and with parenting or not, resulting in four different possibilities and different results for the deformation mode and order of operations. So in this video I'm going to make the rig slightly more complex by adding another deformer. So let's say I want a new weight map, so I'm going to component mode vertices to my right view. I'm going to make a selection of vertices. I could go to my vertex map view to make it visible, go to my lists up here, go to new map, and I'm going to name this move right, for example, with an initial value of 1, so that means 100%. Click OK and you'll see now I have a new weight map with these vertices with a value of 100%. Come back to my shaded view, to perspective mode. So right now the only thing I've done is created a new weight map, and now I have several options. I could use the transform tool, the transform deformer tool up here in the deformers tab, or I can do it manually. I like to do things manually because that makes actually more, especially in these videos, more clearer what exactly is going on. So I'm going to create a locator, because in order to have a deformer I need an effector and an influence, and the effector is going to be my locator. So I've clicked locator icon and you see in the items list I have a new locator. I'm going to pull that one into the schematic view, and for its properties I'm going to name that move right underscore lock. Enter. So now I have a new locator, and with that locator selected, when I press the W key I only move that locator, since it is not part of a deformer setup yet. And I'm going to drop my tool. First, in setup mode I'm going to move that locator to another position, like that for instance. I'm going to parent it in place to my move all locator, and my drop action already has been set to parent in place. So I'm going to click and drag and on top of the move all locator, and now you can see in the item list that my move right locator is a child of the move all locator. With that locator still selected, I'm also going to zero out all so that I can go back to its rest position easily. And as said before, in order to have a deformer I also need an influence. I already have created my weight map, so I have my influence, but in order to make use of that weight map I will need a general influence, and I can create one by going to the deformers tab, new deform item up here, influences, and click general influence. And that general influence has actually been added to my deformer stack, so I can click and drag and pull it in my schematic view. And when I go to its properties, you say it's already been set to type weight map, but for weight map name I can't choose anything because it has not been plugged into anything yet. So in order to do that, I'm going to plug everything in, and I'm also going to, so right now I have a deformer, I have an effector being the move right locator, and I have a general influence, I have an influence being a general influence, and I'm going to set the weight type, the weight map name. It can't set it yet because I have to actually bind it to the mesh, so it's still in setup mode. I'm going to do my bind now, and now when I go to my type weight map it should say, I'm going to refresh maybe, yep, and it already has selected my move right weight map, so move right already had been selected. So right now I have set everything up the way I want to. Go out of setup mode, go to perspective view. First I could give this a slightly smaller display, 40%. So now if I move this locator it moves these vertices. So now through this setup and through plugging everything in, or in other words doing the bind manually in setup mode, now I actually have a deformer And with this effector of that deformer, being the move right locator, I can actually move that part of the mesh. Control Z to undo. So back to my schematic view. Now that I have added a new deformer, I have several options. Do I want the general influence for that deformer to be normalized or not? Like that. And the other option was, do I want parenting or not? And I actually have already parented, so my choices are now only this one, no normalization and parenting, or normalization and parenting. And both will work. They will work slightly different, as I've shown you at the end of the last video, but both will actually work. So right now when I go to my deformers tab, you see that the general influence for my last added deformer is actually outside of the normalizing folder. So what does all of that mean? When I choose that right locator, move it to the right, it works fine. When I move it up, it works fine. Remember, or I should add, for these vertices have also been weighted for the general influence of that deformer, so they also move when I move that deformer. What happens when I rotate everything? Does everything work? No, there seems to be a double transform. So I'm going to my list. I'm without a normalization, without a normalizing folder right now, and I am in the situation of parenting, so my deformation mode of the child should be set to local, and the order of operations is important in the deformer stack. So let's test this out. I'm selecting my move right locator, going to my properties, and set this one to local. This does make a difference. So I have not reordered in the lists, deformers list yet, but I'm first going to check my rig, and you see there still is an undesirable deformation, so my order should be adjusted up here. And in most instances, I think you probably will want to move your child or the general influences of the child deformers to the top of the stack, meaning the bottom of the list. Meaning, remember, the evaluation order in the deformer stack is from the bottom up. So when this is on the bottom of the list, this is on top. Actually, well, it kind of depends, of course, how you look at it. But remember, this deformer stack is being evaluated from the bottom up. So right now, with having dragged my move right underneath the normalizing folder, which contains the general influences for my other deformers, so my move right general influence will be evaluated before my move top and before my move all. And now everything should work fine without extra deformations. So and then even scale this and rotate this, move this just like that, and everything works. So, as I've explained, when you add a deformer or multiple deformers, each time you should ask yourself the question, do I go with normalization or not, and do I go with parenting or not? And depending on these combinations, it becomes important to check out your deformation mode and your order of operations. Now, I have not put the general influence for that new deformer into my normalizing folder, and you might want to ask yourself, can I do that? Yes, you can. Actually, I can move it into my normalizing folder. So now that I've put the general influence for my new deformer into the normalizing folder, I am into a situation where I have normalization for that deformer going on, and it has been parented, so my deformation world should be world. And as I've added here, within the normalizing folder now, the order of operations is actually not important, as I will show you. So my deformation mode should be set to world. Let's test everything out. First I'm going to choose my move top, and you see it does not deform anymore. It does not deform properly anymore, like that. So go to my move right locator, the new the effector for the new deformer that I have added, and I should set this to world, just like in the scheme normalization and parenting, then deformation mode world, but which is a default. I'm going to undo for a moment, so I don't know if you have seen it. So when I set this to world now, then everything pops back into place the way it should work. So now everything again works, and now there actually is normalization going on. And this actually works slightly different, as I've shown you at the end of the last video. There is normalization going on. As explained in the scheme, the order of operations within the normalizing folder actually is not important. So when I zoom in a bit and I reorder the general influences here, and it could be possible that for my, because something seemed to have happened when I go to component mode and to geometry, that I should have done a mesh cleanup. Yep, the face normals are fixed, so it's actually the face normals that actually were not as they should. So now that the order I've put the general influence for the new deformer into the normalizing folder, the order within that normalizing folder actually does not make any difference. At least I have not experienced a situation where it did. But as explained in the scheme, because there now is normalization, my deformation mode should be set to world and not local as it had been done before. And as explained in my previous video, there is a slight difference. I'm going to choose my right one and zoom out a bit, press the W key, and it actually does work a bit differently. This is because now there is normalization going on, so depending on what you want to do, you might want to leave the new deformers outside the normalizing folder, or you might need to put them in, and remember then the deformation mode might be changed. So depending on what your needs are, the difference between this setup, whether it's in the deformation, the normalizing folder or not, is actually being explained on the models forum. So if you want to know exactly why this is, you should do a search on Luxology's forum about double transforms and whatnot, and you will come up with explanations. It actually has to do with the fact that now within a normalizing folder there is normalization going on, meaning Modo is taking care of influences not being able to be above 100%, whereas when this move right general influence was outside my normalizing folder, I'm going to pull it on top out of the normalized folder and then to the bottom, and for my move right locator set it back to local so that everything works. And you see now W, so it works the same, but now when I move my locator, you see the gap between the locator and the geometry remains equal distance, whereas, and I'm going to show you again when I pull it into the normalizing folder, so you see the geometry follows the locator the same amount as I move it, but with the move right locator set to world and the general influence within the normalizing folder, now you see there is a gap between the locator and the geometry, and the further I go, the bigger the gap actually gets. It gets double actually each time. So, and this is because of the normalization. So this might be something that you want to avoid by actually leaving the general influence outside of the normalizing folder and by setting its deformation world to local. And now when I move this, it actually moves as the same amount as I move my locator. This is actually what Andy Brown does when he adds transform deformers for the eyelids. So in the Fireboy tutorial by Andy Brown, at a certain point he creates weight maps for the eyelids, And for each eyelid, he adds a transform deformer. And actually what I've done manually is actually completely the same thing. This is a transform deformer, but I have created it manually. And then when he moves the head bone, or the head joint, or the head locator, whatever you want to call that, then the eyelids, how to say that, they pop out of place, they do a kind of double transform, and he resolves that by putting the general influence for those transform deformers beneath the normalizing folder, so that in the stack they get evaluated first, and he sets the deformation mode for the move right locator to local, and that resolves the problem. So when Andy Brown is doing the Fireboard tutorial and adding transform deformers for the eyelids, he is over here, he is over here, he does not want normalization for those eyelids, and he has parented the effectors of those deformers to the existing rig, so no normalization and parenting, meaning you should set your children, the deformation mode of your children to local, and the order of operations within the deformer stack has become important. So I hope that this makes sense, because it is a very difficult subject matter. I have tried to give you an overview of different possibilities, because when you are doing a tutorial, most of the time, a rigging tutorial, most of the time you are presented with one way of doing things, when actually it can become, that way it can become very difficult to come up with a solution yourself. So hopefully with this video I have explained the difference of the different possibilities you have when you start using deformers, that you can put them in a normalization folder or not, and that you can parent them or not, and that when adding and several combinations of that, meaning you can have, like in this case, a normalized deformers that actually belong to a normalizing folder and that are parented, and then also a deformer, a general influence for the deformer which belong, that not belong to the normalizing folder. And so every time you add a deformer, you should ask yourself, is this going to be part of should this be part of normalization, and should I parent this or not? And then you can check out this scheme to say, well, in this case I'm going to need to set it to world, and I'm going to, if something doesn't work the way it should, reorder, and probably when it's a child deformer, then you are going to put it first in the evaluation stack so that you get the desired result. You will have to do some testing. You could have multiple normalizing folders up here. You can have multiple other folders up here, so you can I could select these ones and put them in a folder. This is just a normal folder for organizational purposes. This doesn't make much sense in this case, but you could have multiple folders, which is just called a deform folder, and you can have multiple normalizing folders. So it can become quite difficult, because the setup, the number of possibilities can become quite complicated. But with each deformer you add, ask yourself, do you want normalization going on? And remember, when I did put my new general influence into the normalizing folder, remember when I dragged my effector further away from it, the effector kind of did the double distance of my actual geometry. So in a lot of cases, and for instance the example I gave about the Fireboy eyelids was an example of that, you do not want that, so you do not want normalization, but you probably are going to do or going to want parenting. So most of the time in such instances, like adding deformers for the eyelids, you are going to want to do deformation mode local, and check out the order of importance is okay up here in the deformer stack. So it is complicated. I hope I did not make things worse, but I feel that this is quite a good scheme in order to not forget what actually should be checked when you are using deformers. So this was Dominic. Bye for now.